Hello, and welcome to my SAS Global Forum presentation. The secret to successful CECL model implementation. My name is Jackie Onchuk, and I am a data scientist at SAS Institute. In my previous role, I was a solutions advisor in the risk division at SAS. In that role, I focused primarily on model implementation for financial institutions. Along with my co-author Monica Wong, have implemented a wide range of CECL methodologies for various financial institutions. In these implementations, we have seen a variety of different challenges arise that we have to face. This presentation covers those challenges, as well as recommendations on ways to overcome them. Our recommendations cover both the design and implementation phases of model development and model implementation, and also include some best practices for writing model implementation code. The implementation and best practice sections are geared towards the SAS Model Implementation Platform solution. This solution has a wide variety of benefits for CECL model implementation that we will discuss further in this presentation. So let's start with the challenges that are often faced in model implementation. These challenges typically fall into the categories of either data gathering and preparation or coding. Data quality checks are essential to ensure data is ready for use in CECL models. Most source data will require some level of effort to impute missing values or correct outliers and erroneous values. Additionally, different types of data joins must be utilized. For example, different portfolios must be joined vertically for reporting and disclosure purposes that may not have been brought together before. Horizontal joins are needed to bring together loan information, potentially from disparate source systems, along with economic data and any other data needed for the model implementation. Once data challenges have been addressed, a large amount of code must be written. This includes forecasting logic, as well as logic to perform sensitivity analysis, attribution analysis, and backtesting. These pieces of logic need to be written for each portfolio, and the resulting code is often lengthy and repetitive. The code can also be very resource intensive if it's not optimized. Keep in mind, it can potentially run for millions of loans across hundreds of horizons and multiple scenarios. If optimization of the code is done, that in and of itself can be a lengthy process. The coding challenges don't end once the code is written. Auditing must occur on this code by internal model validation teams, external auditors, or potentially both. And that lengthy, repetitive code can be time-consuming for the auditors to review. It will also be very difficult for end users to utilize and for any other users maintaining and updating that process. Now that we discussed some of the challenges that will arise in model implementation, let's talk about how to address them, starting with design. Many of the challenges discussed in the previous slide can and should be addressed in the design phases of both model development and model implementation. Decisions made in model design have effects on model implementation. For example, data preparation, model creation, and model execution code should be separated out in model development. This is because only data preparation code and model execution code will be utilized in that production cycle. If these pieces are intertwined, additional effort must be taken to separate them. That effort would be unnecessary if those pieces were separate in the first place. Additionally, variable availability should be considered in model development. For example, variables such as the occurrence of a natural disaster may be highly predictive for default probability, but may not be available in the production cycle. Process automation should also be considered. Some data may require manual preparation for model development. It should be considered how that manual preparation will be automated for the CECL production cycle. It might be necessary to redesign or remove that data preparation component so that it can be incorporated into the overall CECL process. Data sourcing may differ for model development and model implementation. If that's the case, thought has to be given to how the data will be brought into the CECL cycle and if any processing must be done to that data so it aligns with the model development data. SAS Model Implementation Platform has many benefits when it comes to model implementation design and coding. It reduces the amount of code that needs to be written. The only code that needs to be written is to extract data from source systems and forecasting logic. No code needs to be written for combining input loan data with economic data or combining different portfolios' outputs. It has standardized templates to run attribution, sensitivity, and backtesting analyses. Code within Model Implementation Platform has the ability to be locked down to any further changes while also being fully transparent, which is perfect for auditing. Because of its reduced coding effort and friendly user interface, usability and maintenance can occur very easily. Now, while Model Implementation Platform simplifies many of the CECL model implementation components, there are still important questions to consider when performing the model implementation design in order to best utilize the solution. Model Implementation Platform refers to individual equations as model objects. A model group contains model objects as well as the code that uses the model objects to calculate outputs. Now there are two types of model groups, scoring and evaluation. Aggregate level methodologies can be incorporated into scoring model groups, whereas loan level methodologies can be run using evaluation model groups. This allows aggregate level calculations to execute for each distinct aggregate level value, like customer ID, for greater coding and runtime efficiency than if they were run for each loan. If portfolios have similar methodologies, but individual models have different variables or equations, the same model group can be used to run them. The code to perform the segmentation can be incorporated into the model group, so each appropriate atomic model is called for each loan. If a methodology uses transition matrices, consider whether the transition matrix entries are static values over time, or each cell is an equation that must be executed in each horizon. SAS Model Implementation Platform supports and streamlines coding for both types, but in different ways. To source additional data besides snapshot loan information and economic data, datasets called risk data objects are used. To incorporate static lookup tables, utilize parameter matrices. To incorporate loan level information that changes over time in a predefined manner, use value datasets. For greatest efficiency, Model Implementation Platform separates model variables into three different types: static, variables that don't change over time, such as origination credit score, age indexed, variables that change over time in a predefined manner, such as a loan's age, and simulation, variables that change over time in an unknown way, such as months since last delinquency. Classifying variables appropriately tells Model Implementation Platform when to calculate them, so that their values are only calculated as needed. Model documentation is also important. It should include information on the methodology, as well as any complex variable calculations. This expedites the ramp up on the CECL models for auditors, end users, and new users. Finally, consider what output variables will be needed in different stages. For example, the production cycle may require fewer output variables than testing or ad hoc analyses. The more variables that are output, the longer the code will take to run. So be sure you're specifying within Model Implementation Platform which variables should be output to best suit your needs. Once these implementation questions are answered, the code is ready to be written. When writing code within Model Implementation Platform, these are some best practices to follow. Efficiency is very important. While Model Implementation Platform is itself a very efficient solution, since code will be executing for the life of every loan in your financial institution's portfolio, it's important that the code is written as efficient as it can be. Minimizing string comparisons, the usage of the dynamic array subroutine, and the int nx and int ck functions are all easy ways to make your code more efficient. Model Implementation Platform also generates system variables you can leverage to make your code run more efficiently. For example, the variable terminate rep will stop the execution for a given loan when its value is set to 1. This will eliminate unnecessary calculations, as not all loans will mature at the same time. One more tip is to read entire rows or columns of parameter matrices rather than individual values, if multiple values from the parameter matrix will be needed. Other best practices are important for ensuring expected results and streamlining code. Clearing arrays, resetting temporary variables, and checking return codes are all important to make sure your code is functioning as expected. Model Implementation Platform has a transition matrix object, which stores multiple model objects. One trick is to use the transition matrix object to call multiple models at the same time, even when the models are not transition models. Users can write functions in Model Implementation Platform to call common pieces of logic across model groups. These are also excellent ways to streamline your code. Utilize value datasets instead of cash flow datasets, as cash flow datasets have more stringent requirements. For additional details on these best practices, please see our paper. As discussed, there is so much to consider when implementing CECL methodologies. While model development is very important, the implementation of CECL models as part of the production cycle should not be an afterthought. Model implementation requires appropriate time and consideration to be done in the most efficient, transparent, and auditable way possible as CECL goes into effect. Thank you so much for watching my presentation today. For more in-depth discussions of this topic, please see the paper that Monica Wong and I wrote on this topic. And please feel free to contact us with any questions.